بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. طيب كونسبتس معينة قبل ما نتكلم. طيب today we are going to talk about types of the moons management. What are the complications that may happen to these ones? The first one that we will talk about في principles معينة يا شباب دائما مهم ان نحطها في بالنا. صوتي واضح؟ احتاج احد يرد علي يقول لي واضح، ابغى اسمع صوتي. نحط الصورة هذه أول شيء من بتكلم عنها. شباب أول شيء في كونسبت معينة في الجراحة we should know it very well so that when we once we know what is the pathology of it we will be able to know how to treat it. في شيء اسمه sinus، في شيء اسمه fistula. تعرف sinus؟ It's a blind trunk. It's an opening at the skin or at the mucosa that is without a tract. مش معنى without a tract يعني other opening that will open with it. يعني مثلا خلينا نشوف هنا. شوف الصورة هذه. أو الصورة هذه. شوفوا يا شباب. السيتون الخيط اللي محطوط هنا محطوط في شيء اسمه فيستولا. فيستولا عبارة عن opening at the site internally and open at the external. It's an opening only outside. There is no internal opening or there is no tract on site. وهنا على أساس this is the concept of the treatment of each of them. So sinus, it's a blind tract lined by granulation tissue leading from epithelial surface. Usually it could be congenital or acquired. Congenital usually due to examples are periauricular sinus. Acquired usually it's due to TB. Actinomycosis usually acquired due to a cause, either infection or either inflammatory. Fistula, it's an opening between two structures or between two organs. Could be internal or external. الفكرة إنه it is an opening between two epithelial tissue. يعني مثل ما شفنا الصورة اللي قبل شوي. It could be from the anal parts opening, the internal part of the opening at the anal part or external part of the opening at the skin. هذا اللي يسمونها external fistula. Internal fistula, it could be between the internal organs, between مثلا small bowel or large bowel. هذه اسمها internal fistula. طيب الـ causes طبعا الـ fistula, it could be congenital. The brachial fistula, tracheostomial, umbilical, thyroglossal fistula. Congenital cause also congenital physiology, pathophysiology of the fistula. It arises from remnant of the embryonic duct and persists instead of being obliterated and disappearing completely during the embryonic development. يعني شيء بقي لم يختفي from the من الامبريولوجي. So now it is considered as a foreign body and there is a reaction either with it or around it and which led to a fistula. طبعا يا شباب الفستولا بتعريفها once it is discovered usually it is considered يعني most of it is considered an abnormality. يعني لما تلقى a fistula between two structures معناها انه there is something happened formed this fistula. Acquired causes either after surgery like intestinal fistula or following instrumentation after labor, like psychovaginal, rectovaginal fistula. It could be inflammatory. It could be due to a cancer. It could be iatrogenic. It could fistulas according to the types. It could be cutaneous. It could be tracheoesophageal. يعني ترى divide division حقها كثير. لكن the most important thing that once we know what's the type, what is the cause, we will be able to manage. طيب fistula as we said it's an abnormal opening between epithelial structure with an epithelial tract with it, يعني external opening and internal opening, and there is a tract between them. هذه أنواع types: tenuous, anterovesical, rectovesical, vesicovesical, sorry, vesicovaginal, tracheoesophageal, arteriovenous. This is the types or the most common types of fistula. طبعا anorectal fistula لو تشوفون dentate line, beside the dentate line there is a tract internally and externally beside the external sphincter, which one واضحة هنا. It will give you a hint. كيف؟
في قرم، حدد بالقرم عشان النمو
ما يطلع عندي النار. وين القلم؟ انا ما يعرف اطلع القلم، وين القلم؟
فوق على اليمين، على الشيء فوق اليمين.
ايه.
في زي الاصبع يا دكتور، اصبع.
هذه واضحة الحين؟
اي واضح.
This is a fistula. This is the internal opening. This is the external opening. This is the tract between them. واضحة؟ Okay. Usually the patient will come as secretions coming from here and coming outside. هنا. Our patient will come as a collection here. Considered a perianal access. Anorectal fistula, نفس هذه نفس الفكرة, لكن this is after treatment, هذا الشيء, it's called seton. This is the perianal abscess. Usually, most of the perianal abscess, 30%, 30% of perianal abscess will change after drainage and become fistula, perianal fistula that needs treatment. Okay. At the rectovaginal fistula, usually it's a fistula that appear after delivery or due to episiotomy. In a shabab, usually. See? This is an opening between the rectum and the vagina. This is the vagina. This is the rectum. Patient usually either will have stool coming from here, and usually they will come with a vaginal infection, and usually this complication make the patient unable to have their problem, their menstrual period, so many infections in this area. طبعا the management get غالبا it's combined between the gynae and the cervix. Arteriovenous fistula, it's a fistula which is formed by the surgeon, and there is a direct communication between the fist, between the arterial and the venous part, usually due to for dialysis patient. The tracheotenous fistula, it's a fistula between the tracheum and the skin. Usually if patient غالبًا it is either due to radiation or due to infection of a congenital remnant. Orocutaneous fistula between the oral cavity and the mouth. Periauricular sinus. طبعا لو تشوفوا شباب sinus and fistula. طبعا الفكرة انه how do you know that This is a sinus or this is the fistula. You need according to the symptoms of the patient. طبعا هذا الشيء هو اتكلم فيه اللي is the part of management regarding ال ENT. لكن surgical wise, once you need to treat a sinus or the fistula, a sinus, we know that is an opening, which is there is no another opening. So the treatment is to open and to remove the granulation tissue here. But regarding fistula, there is an external and internal opening. And usually, if it's related to the anorectal part, you should very important define the anatomy and dissect the two parts involved. يعني زي هنا إنه مثلاً anterior cutaneous fistula. لو تشوفين large bowel or skin, usually there is an opening between. There is an opening here and opening here. And there is a tract here between them. So stool will come here outside. So what's the symptoms of the patient? Patient will come with weight loss. Patient will come with discharge. Patient will come with stool coming from the skin. Patient will come sometimes with loss of appetite. Usually it could be part of Crohn's. عماد انا ما احب المقاطع كذا يلين بس اخلص الكونسبت بعدين تفضل يا عماد. طيب تفضل. تفضل يا عماد.
يمكن ضغطها بالغلط يا دكتور. السيمبتومز تكون على حسب مكان الفستيلا ولا اي مكان؟
According to the organ involved, if it's small bowel or large bowel. If it's small bowel, it will be bile coming from here. It's a high out because small bowel is the area of absorption. Usually the area of the skin will be affected by the alkaline. The alkaline bile, patient will be having malnutrition because these patients are unable to get benefit from the food they are eating, so it is not being absorbed. But if the part involved is large bowel, stool will be coming. Usually the patient will have less output, like it's stool coming. So stool, it's يعني stool coming from an abnormal opening. A risk of infection high, a risk of wound dehiscence, a risk of necrotizing fasciitis كلها because of this infected secretion. Regarding the wounds, what types of the wounds, طبعا في محاضرة ثانية يعني فيها تفاصيل of the wounds, لكن بس أنا حبيت أحط هذه عشان نعرف إنه there are so many types of wound. There is acute and chronic parts. طيب, what is the concept between each one of them? Usually the acute wounds that happen acutely, يعني within a short period, and they are able to quickly. The chronic wounds, usually the wounds who do not heal quickly and they need long time, and each one of them has its own cause. طبعا ال wound healing وال what is the types of the wound healings. طيب الفكرة أول شيء دائما الأكيوت wound, it is the wound that will happen in a short period and it will close easily. هذا ما منه خوف, يعني it's a wound كأنك abrasion or laceration in the hand on the lower limb. Usually the treat according to the wound itself, نتكلم عنها بعدين. And usually these wounds, if there's nothing will prevent their healing, they will close easily. لكن المشكلة دائما مع الكرونيك wound. الكرونيك wound the wound that failed to heal in a given period of time, either and they are according to the etiology and the location of the tissue tab. Usually there is disturbance of the normal process of the wound healing, which will lead to poor anatomy and a poor functional result. Either will be arrest or slowing in the inflammatory process. There's an increase of the metalloproteinase binding and degrading cytokines. There is a problem with the healing process itself. Let's talk about the healing process. Okay. What are the causes that will affect the wound healing? Once you know what's the cause, you will be able to treat the wound and you will be able to make it better. طبعا الwound healing, there is an intrinsic factor and an extrinsic factor. Intrinsic factor, that's main factors within the body. Ischemia, hypoxia, infection, foreign body, chronic venous insufficiency, ionizing radiation, edema, decrease in the growth factor. These are factors which is that is from the body itself. Extrinsic factor, that's due to a cause from outside. Malnutrition, diabetes. Malnutrition, patient is not taking proper eating. So when he is not eating properly, there is no growth factor. Once he will eat, he will grow. Diabetes mellitus, once you are able to treat the diabetes mellitus, the patient healing process will be able. Steroids, medication, collagen fast disease, any cleansing agents, methyl bovidine, trauma, chronic diseases, and some hematological disorders like sickle cell anemia. أنا بس أبغى الفكرة عندي يا شباب إنه once you think that a patient is not healing properly and you know the cause, treat it. يعني مثلا patient على steroid, you will ask him to stop steroid. Patient smoking, you will stop smoking. If he's this patient sometimes is using so much of cleaning agents, يعني مريض جالس في بعض الناس عنده زي كذا الفوبيا المعينة ف he's cleaning the wound two times or three times per day by bovidine. Bovidine usually it affect the healing process by affecting the microphages, affect their migration and healing part. ف مهم جدا انه to put in your mind that once there is a cause, there is unhealed wound, you should know what's the cause. طيب the intrinsic factor, patient is his wound is not cleaning and there is a foreign body that's forgotten inside, يعني patient trauma وصار عنده جرح في يده and clean the wound and still after 1 week and 2 weeks the wound is not healing. Sometimes there is some debris, glasses, يعني حاجة منعت healing process. So you need to examine the wound properly and you need to irrigate it. And if there is any foreign body, you need to remove it. طبعا. This is a chart that will guide you what may cause, يعني مثلا patient with diabetes mellitus. Usually their wound will not heal because of the atherosclerosis, improper blood supply, and there is pre-vascular fibrosis and the edema, which all lead to something called hypoxia. So that's mean, once there is hypoxia, bacterial load will be high. There is no blood coming, so ischemia, and cells will die. That's mean, the more inflammation. طب واحد يسألني طيب what are the types of the wounds or chronic wounds. The most common دائما chronic wounds is diabetic foot ulcers and usually they are either due to neuropathic or ischemic. Other types are arterial or venous, some skin tears, pressure sores, ionizing radiations. طبعا the most common دائما diabetic والvenous. الايونايزنج والبريشر سورس يجي بعدها، لكن الفكره انه يعني مثلا شوف الصوره هذه This is a venous ulcer. This is a diabetic foot or a diabetic ulcer. This is a bit sore. These wounds develop either due to venous or arterial, due to ischemia and improper blood supply. Diabetic foot either due to neuropathic or ischemic and repeated trauma. The pressure or the bit sore usually due to pressure that will affect the blood supply in this area. Diabetic foot ulcer usually is ulcer due to a neuropathy, first a trauma, then a neuropathy, and associated infection and ischemia. طبعا هي عبارة عن زي المثلث المقلوب. يعني usually a patient diabetic foot, يعني how to start. يعني patient diabetic foot usually they are having diabetes for a long time. And their blood sugar is not being controlled. So that's mean there is a pancreas. There will be affection of the nerve supply. Then the most infected or easily infected is the vessels. The nerves, the vasa nervosa. So there will be deposition of something called sorbitol. So once there is deposition, there will be demyelination. So the patient will lose, the nerve will lose its function. And the patient will not be able to feel. معناها no feeling. The patient will walk and he will hit something and he will not be able to feel it. Yeah. ما عاد في nerve. لأنه nerve خلاص صار له demyelination and nerve is affected. Once it's affected, معناها the patient ممكن يمشي يدعس له حاجة حارة يدعس له حصى يدخل في رجله حاجة وما يدري عنها. معناها it's a foreign body that will cause infection. Other way of developing diabetic foot ulcer due to the atherosclerosis that will affect the blood supply. So this means there is no ischemia. So the tissue will be weak. The tissue will be easily to get infection. So once it develops infection, it will go suck. Infection, either neuropathy, infection, or ischemia will come infection. All about developing an ulcer. Ionizing radiation, early and delayed, these all things affect the healing process. Once you patient coming with a chronic ulcer, it's very important to know this ulcer, what is the type of it, other types of chronic ulcer, something called marginal ulcer. This is about due to chronic unhealing process. It's an aggressive ulceration. The wound itself become containing squamous cell carcinoma. So the treatment, you should take a biopsy and ensure usually it's due to the a chronic burn injury or a chronic varicose veins. And usually patient will come with chronic osteomyelitis and scar. So treatment are very important. To take biopsy. Once you take biopsy, you will know, is it a chronic ulcer due to only inflammatory cells or the wound become a squamous cell carcinoma ulcer. Very important, so that because according to it, you will guide your next treatment. Either you will do amputation or you will do will you do aggressive excision of the area and according to the place itself. طيب واحد يسألني طيب دكتور how can we avoid these things, يعني how can we avoid developing a chronic wound or how can we help the wound to heal properly. طبعا في كده في pre-operative inter-operative prophylactic measures that will make the wound easily to heal and less likely to develop a chronic wound. يعني مثلا you would ask the patient before surgery to stop smoking for 30 days. طبعا انت يعني الشيء هذا يعني اكبر دليل على نقول انه وقايه خير من علاج. يعني لان السموكينج itself affect the healing process. So stopping the smoking for 30 days before surgery, طبعا كل هذا بروفيلاكتيك يا شباب. Will help the wound to heal properly. If the patient is malnutrition, you will help him to enhance his nutrition status. Chlorpexidine before the surgery. Remove the hair immediately before surgery. Giving antibiotic 60 minutes before incision. Clean your hands as a surgeon properly for 2 minutes. Surgical site, clean it properly. Prevent any hypothermia, good glycemic control, and gentle tissue. These all things will help the healing process and will make the healing process more easy. What are the types of wound classification? These are classification of the wound according to the it's according to the, is it clean or not. طبعا الجدول هذا مهم جدا بالنسبه لي لانه once you know what is the type of the surgery, you will be able to prepare the patient and take the measure and the preventive measuring procedures that will make the wound heal. يعني ايش معنى hernia surgery. Hernia surgery, the rate of, لأنه it's a clean surgery. Why it's a clean surgery? It is non-traumatic. It's an elective surgery. Usually it is a surgery that's not involving the GI tract or respiratory tract or genitourinary tract. They are not opt. So these, مهم جدا يا شباب نعرف الكونسبت عشان لما أسأل عن أي type of surgery, you should know. Hernia, there is no, first it's not non-traumatic, it's an elective, it is not involving the GI tract, it's not involving the respiratory, it's not involving the genitourinary tract. So it's a clean surgery. So the risk of infection is 2%. يعني لما سوي 100 شخص, 2 people who are going to get the infection, بس. Then usually the infection will come from him. لكن once there is increase of the infection, معناها في measurement, there is something wrong happened. Mastectomy, vascular surgery, all these surgeries, they are not involving an entrance to the GIT or respiratory or genital. And all these things are elective. But then a clean contaminated. A clean contaminated surgeries that will be minimal contamination, مثل laparoscopic cholecystectomy, gastrectomy, hysterectomy. These surgeries, usually there is a minimal contamination. يعني إيش معناها؟ These surgeries patient will be prepared before surgery. إيش معنى prepared؟ يعني if it's gastrectomy the patient will يعني راح ينحط له NGT, gastric lavage, يعني تتنظف الستمك من الأشياء هذه. Lab coli once you cut the biliary system, because of the duodenum, لأنه البليري ينزل عليه. So sometimes you can feel flow back من الجدن and causing risk of infection. So these are surgeries called clean contaminated surgeries. And usually giving the patient a prophylactic antibiotic for the surgery will decrease the rate of the infection less than 10%. واضح كلامي ولا لا يا شباب؟ أحتاج أحد يرد عليه. واضح. طيب يا عبد الله تفضل.
يعني دكتور مع البروفلاكتيك ينزل الريت اوف انفكشن الى
10%.
مع البروفلاكتيك انتي بايوتكس ينزل الريت اوف انفكشن الى 10%.
البروفلاكتيك ميجرز, معنى بروفلاكتيك ميجرز يعني نفس الكلام اللي قلته. You will clean the wound properly, you will give antibiotics, you will enhance the nutritional status. هذه الاشياء ما هو بس انتيبيوتيك. طيب contaminated, it's an open fresh traumatic wound, uncontrolled spillage with a minor breakage of the sterile technique like rupture appendix, emergent or resection, the rate of infection is 20%. Dirty, open traumatic perforation of a hollow fissus, frank pus of the field, like intestinal fistula resection, a rate of infection of 28 to 70%. دائما لما ديفيند الوند that is coming as an emergency patient is مثلا عنده ruptured bowel and the bowel and the stool is inside the abdominal cavity, هذه a dirty wound. طيب wound management facilitate body healing mechanism, optimal function to resume the cosmetic appearance, remove all the tissue, potential infective or individualized tissue should be removed. Any tissue which is not healthy will affect the healing. Remove any collision if there is no blood supply, enhance the hemostasis, give tetanus, give antibiotic. If the patient is having risk of renal failure, improve his renal status, try to help avoid compartment syndrome. Usually patient with according to the itself, يعني مثلا if it bite, which type of bite, and according to it manage. Like it's, if it's a venom bite, usually a venom bite or a scorpion bite, they will يعني increase the risk of hypercoagulable status. So these patients should be given anticoagulant. If a patient coming with a burn, good hydration, analgesic dressing, debridement, and later grafting. طبعا wound closer material, open wounds with a dressing, direct, the skin adhesions, steel strips, suture, skin grafting, surgical flap, negative pressure, حاجة يسمونها back machine, إلها صور. The future advances that will enhance healing using and materials that will still under study to enhance the healing, like مثلا human cell derived factors, hyperbaric oxygen, honey, platelet rich plasma, nutritional improved, appropriate neurological stimulation, engineered tissue material, stem cells. يعني كل هذه حاجة futures, and if you can help in the future to develop new modalities. تكلمنا عن سوتشر like this one, this is stitch, this is steady step strips, this is stabler. طبعا كل هذه modalities to close. This is back machine, شوف هذه اللي في الصورة B. This is back machine, patient جايني wound, it's a wound, it will take a long time till it heal, so I will apply the back machine. Live machine, it's concepts that it will enhance the حد يعرف عنها المشينة حد سمع عنها
الله يا دكتور أول مرة.
It enhance angiogenesis, شو معنى angiogenesis؟ It enhance the information of new blood vessels. So once there is a new blood vessels, that means there will be more blood supply, so healing process will be easier and faster. This one of the modalities of to help the wound to heal itself, which is debridement and removing of the dead tissue and flowing it. Once you remove the dead tissue, this red part or this pink part will be more granulation tissue and will heal quickly and easy. This is using skin flap and skin graft, usually by the blast people, to cover a big area and enhance the healing. الحين الفكرة تكلمنا عن الباثوفيسيولوجي والتايبس كل حاجة, لكن how can we apply it clinically? Applying it clinically, when you take a sleep with the patient, you will ask, is it new? Is it a current? Is it a chronic? Onset, duration and progression, improving and worsening. Ask about any extrinsic factor that may affect the healing. HIV, steroids, chemotherapy, diabetes, peripheral vascular disease, radiation, smoking. All these things will guide you to know what's the type and what are the complications and what is the the things that will affect the healing of this. And patient غالبا احنا اللي بنشوفها diabetic ulcer. Diabetic ulcer. Usually he will tell you that it's this is a this is an ulcer that started before 2 months مثلا. And this is the first time I develop it, or it is multiple. I had it several times. This happened when I was walking, suddenly I saw it. The wound, I noticed that it is increasing in size and is associated discharge with it. There's redness of the skin I noticed around it. That means it's getting infection. My diabetes is not controlled. And I had before 2 years a heart attack. And I'm using smoking. I'm smoking 2 packs a day. This is a history. It will guide you. That's an ulcer. That's a chronic ulcer. That it will not heal properly. And there are so many factors that affecting its healing. Examination, site, size, depth, and tissue involved. Any signs of the infection, like redness, discharge, tenderness, any swelling, change of the color, any bad odor. Then you will do vascular assessment and neurological assessment. And I check the wound, what is around the wound, any enlarged lymph nodes, any other ulcer around it, send for labs and do X-ray or radiological investigation. This is the wound, the wound edge, the wound cavity, the base of the wound. The base usually, شباب, دائما, once it is full of granulation tissue, معنا it will heal. Usually, once you are able to see to assess the wound properly and remove the foreign body, تفضل عبد الله.
معلش دكتور رفعت لي اليد مرفوعة ما أشوفها.
الكلينيكال اسسمنت اوف الالسر يعني مثل ما قلنا احنا التايبس ايذر فينس ارتيريال نيوروباثيك تروماتيك اور مالجننت السايت اكوردنج تو ذا سايت يوجوالي الفينس ات ذا جريتر اريا اند لاترال بارت ذس از ذا يوجوالي ذا ارتيريال ات ذا ميليوراي اور ذا اور ذا ميتاتارسال هيد اوف ذا سكند ميتاتارسال بيس نيوروباثيك ات ذا بريجر اريا تروما ذا سايد اوف ذا تروما malignant usually according to the area like base lip trunk. طبعا الفكره عند الالسرز هذه يا شباب انه في التفينس ألسر it will be irregular sloping and granulation tissue. في concepts معينه في شيء اسمه edge. Edge will be sloping. Floor will be full of granulation tissue. Margin that's mean it the margins which is a relation to the what's around structure يعني relation to the skin it will be irregular. الفكرة عندي في هذا الشارت انه you will be able to know what is the type of the venous sorry what's the type of the ulcer according to its examination and in neuropathic it will be bunched out. So that's mean that this is a bunched out ulcer usually due to neuropathic neurotrophic part or neuropathic tract part and it is floor will be slough. صورة بعدين برسلها الرحمن will be it will be make it will make it easier for you. برسلها لكم. تذكرون محاضرة ال يمكن نتكلم عن الفاسكولار clinical vascular assessment. This is the brachial index which will help you to assess the blood supply and then what it will help you to guide the treatment of the patient and enhance his circulation. If it's normal, it will be from 0.9 to 1. If there is a vascular disease between 0.6 to 0.9, less, so that means worse vascular disease. And معناها not heal. One of the complications that may happen due to the infected ulcers, infected wound, which is gangrene. Gangrene, that's there is a death of the tissue and necrosis. Usually it occurs due to the lack of the blood supply or infection. Types of the dry and wet gangrene and gas gangrene. Dry gangrene is a gangrene that occurs during the empty foot and there is will be gradual reduction of the blood supply at acute. There is no infection associated. Wet gangrene, there is infection and decrease in the blood supply. And usually once you treat it, the gangrene stop, lakin it will stop by stopping the infection and enhancing the blood supply. Gas gangrene usually due to the infection that will cause death of the tube and formation of gas inside the wound. Hydrofornir gangrene is type of perineal and scrotum infection due to gas forming organism, and usually the skin outside either will be discolored or will be normal, and the collection will be at the subcutaneous area associated with gases. Treatment, aggressive, emergent and aggressive debridement to this area and may improve the patient condition. Yeah, usually fornir gangrene will occur in a patient with collection, patient with uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, and once he developed this subcutaneous infection, very important to make aggressive debridement, cover with spectrum antibiotic, control his blood sugar and enhance his circulation, and daily aggressive dressing also. طبعا نفس ما تكلمنا على الغاز غانغرين usually by clostridium perfringens organism. Usually skin will appear. Other types of gangrene called internal gangrene. في طبعا internal external. الفكرة انه gangrene when it occur. That means there is an infection and decrease in the blood supply and it should be treated. طبعا الموضوع الوند شباب موضوع كبير. يعني اللي بيقرأ في البليند لوف شوف الموضوع متشعب. أنا حاولت قد ما أقدر أغطي وتكلم عن most of the types of the wound في باقي المحاضرة الثانية. لكن في concepts معينة قبل لا أتكلم في الباثوفيسيولوجي والأشياء كنت أبغاها تنعرف. أوكي. أي سؤال قبل المحاضرة الثانية؟
دكتور الحين حتى الجنجرين هذا كيف تصير وين صح؟ حتى لو انه ما في شيء
لا انترنال الجنجرين احنا اذا وصلنا لمرحله انترنال بعد يهمني وقت ولا درايف لانه انترنال الجنجرين في سمول ديستن مثلا ناخذ مثل خلاص يوجولي سمول انتستن حتى ات ويل بي يوجولي انا ما ودي انك تربطها اكيوت ولا او دراي اور ويت دائما الدراي والويت جرين ابير تكون على الاكسترنال ذا لور لمب بيجيك بيشن دايبتك فوت عنده دراي ولا ويت جرين الدراي جرين معناها انه ذس جرين از سينس لونج تايم اند از هافينج كرونيك ارتيريال انسفيشنسي خلت المريض يدخل في مرحله الجرين لكن نيود ولا انترنال جرين ات از ان اكيوت gangrene. يعني مريض كان عنده fine suddenly he developed internal gangrene in the small intestine due to the thrombus or emboli. ما في شيء internal part اسمه dry or wet gangrene. لأنه dry or wet gangrene غالبا externally. lower limb, fingers, شو اسمه هذا؟ زي ما قلنا الفورنير gangrene الأشياء هذه. لكن internal يعني خلاص انت في النهاية هدفك internally to save the patient life ما يهمني internal ولا sorry ما يهمني dry ولا wet gangrene small bowel إذا دخلت ولقيتها والله dry بقول والله بخليها لا ال concept to save his life appendix usually غالب الابندكس اللي تجيك wet gangrene لكن ما إحنا surgically ما نهتم منها wet ولا dry الابندكس لأنه at the end I will remove it لكن usually it is a type of gangrene that's associated with infection. فمعناها انه كمصطلح it is a wet gangrene, not a dry gangrene. أي سؤال ثاني؟ Yes. Yes. It is formed by gas-forming organism. طبعاً this is the most common organism. لأنه دائماً diabetic patient they are immunocompromised. Sometimes they will have a mixed type of infection. يعني ممكن يكون عنده more than organism that caused the infection. لكن this is the most common part. Sorry, the most common organism. عشان كده we are covering them with the broad spectrum antibiotic. تفضل. يبي يسأل. سؤال ثاني شباب نروح المحاضرة اللي بعدها.
الله يعطيك العافية دكتور.
طيب. بالله السلام يا عبد الرحمن توك داخل. طيب السلام عليكم.
السلام.
Just for some refreshment, wounds is a separation of the or discontinuity of the skin, either the mucous membrane of the skin or the any tissue caused by physical or chemical or biological insult. The wound care is the primary goal. The primary goal is to clean the wound and repair it and optimize or provide an optimal condition for a good healing response. في حاجة بسرعة أتأكد منها. طبعاً بس أبغى لو تلاحظون يا شباب المحاضرتين اللي هو المحاضرة الأولى وونز 1 وونز 2 في الجدول، أنا حاولت قد ما أقدر إني put it away that كلها وونز، يعني الألسر هو وونز، الساينس هو وونز، فيستيلا كلها وونز، فأنا قد ما أقدر حاولت to do mixing of it، ما حاولت إني أفصلهم عن بعض، إنه في النهاية الفيستيلا إذا كان في infection ما راح تقفل. والساينس إذا في إنفكشن ما راح تكفل، والألسر هنا كل بعض، لكن احنا قسمناها على ساعتين علشان نبدأ يعني we can go with details. يعني الوند هيلينج يعني أنا كانت كفر الوند هيلينج all of it في المحاضرة الأولى، so I need to cover it in the other lecture or to know the pathophysiology and why it is happening. فعشان كده الشباب اللي بيقرأ المحاضرة هي عبارة عن محاضرتين جزئين عن بعض، يعني ما هي محاضرة هذه الحالة وهذه الحالة. أتمنى الواحد لما يقرأ التوبك يقرأ كاملا كوند، ما هو يقرأ بس كأشياء منفصلة عن بعض عشان يقدر يربط لها. طيب الفكرة أن الـ goals of wound care to facilitate hemostasis, decrease tissue loss and promote healing and minimize scar formation. نفس الفكرة الهيستوري سيمتومز، what is the type of the injury, if there is any infection, what happened exactly, did he, it is a thermal effect or he was hit by foreign body, there is any possibility of foreign body inside it, is the area is affected, is functioning properly, can he move his foot or not, there is any trauma with it, check his tetanus status, any allergy, any medication, comorbidities and in the previous scar formation. Wound examination, نفس ما قلنا, site size, margin, depth, with relation to the skin, neurofunctional, vascular, tendon, underlying structure, wound contamination and foreign body. Management, wound preparations, give painkiller or lidocaine, hemostasis, remove the foreign body, hair removal, cleaning with normal saline, debridement, antibiotic, tetanus to control his medical problem, dressing, keep the dressing for not open for 24 to 48 hours, protect the notes, sutures will be removed in the face after 3 to 5 days, in the arm after 7 days, in the anterior trunk after 7 days, in the back 10 to 14 days, in the feet 10 to 14 days, in the joint as well, and the scalp. This is one of the things for making the wound to heal better. إنك تخلي ال stitch to stay for this specific time. يعني مثلا في الفيس لو تركتها 2 weeks it will increase the risk of scar. It will be considered as a foreign body. there will be a risk of infection. هنا أنا هذا أساس المحاضرة اللي إذا فهمناها إحنا we will assess, we will be able to understand the other things, especially the chronic wounds that will have difficulty to be healed. طيب الحين نجي الفكرة إنه the healing process itself, there are some organs, there will be regeneration or formation of a new tissue, which is the same as the original tissue, and there is other type that will not heal with not will they will not heal with the regeneration, they will heal with a scar. مثل الليفر. زي ما تسمعون يا شباب الليفر دونيشن وما ليفر دونيشن. Once the a person donate his part of the liver, this part will be replaced with the same liver tissue after a while. يعني غالبا من 6 الى 6 شهور الى سنه. لكن الفكره انه it will not heal by a scar. This is only seen in the liver. But in other tissues, the healing will be with a scar. مثل في الهارت. مثلا once the patient developed an MI, يحصل عنده ischemia في الهارت. الهيلينج will be in the ischemic part as a fibrosis. عشان كذا the patient later will have decrease in the cardiac performance, لأنه the replaced scar tissue is not like the normal tissue. واضح كلامي ولا يا شباب؟
يس يعني الهيلينج دكتور يختلف في نفس الوند.
طيب. طيب. الفكره انه there are two types of healing, either a regeneration or formation the same tissue or a formation of the scar. مثل في الليفر. الليفر what happens in liver donation, once a person donates part of the liver, this removed part will be replaced later with the same liver tissue. But if it's in other tissues like in heart, if the patient developed ischemia, the dead part of the heart will be replaced later with fibrous tissue and scar. طيب wound healing is the summation of a number of processes including coagulation, inflammation and matrix synthesis and deposition and eugenesis, fibroplasia, epithelialization and contraction and remodeling and scar maturation. Angiogenesis and fibroblast proliferation is the result of the formation of granulation tissue. طيب in a wound healing it will start with a bleeding, formation of the blood clot and inflammatory with migration of the fibroblast and macrophages, then there will be proliferation of the fibroblast, healing of the wound. Then after that, once it is proliferated, there will be remodeling of the tissue. Wound classification system provide framework. It will end diagnosis, certification, ensure uniformity, documentation, and other prognostic factor types of the wound classification. There will be a code classified according to the etiology, according to the duration of the wound, healing according to the integrity of the skin, according to the. This is the classification. يعني في several types. يعني Billy and Love محدد several types of classification. يعني ممكن according to the cause. Is it traumatic cause or due to neuropathic cause? Or the duration is an acute or chronic, or according to the integrity of the skin, according to the depth, is it long or deep or shallow, according to the morphological character, according to contamination, clean contaminated, according to severity, and several ways of to assess the clean the wound from etiology, as we said. Can be classified blunt, penetrating, surgical, burn, blunt like RTA fall, penetrating like stab wound, surgical wounds like this is a wound that caused by surgical procedure, burn. هذه كل أشياء واضحة. طيب نفس الclassification wound classification that of the wounds that will be untidy, that mean unclean that occur after crush injury or tearing. Vascular or burn, usually these this type of infection usually associated if there is any fractures, and they usually occur either they can close primarily or secondary. Primary or secondary, so هذه لين نجي لآخر المحاضرة. But at the same time, according to the duration of the wound, acute or chronic, chronic wounds, usually they are wounds that fails to heal, except after that fails to heal after 4 weeks to 3 months. Usually there are causes, poor circulation, poor nutrition, venous ulcer, diabetic foot are an example. Type. According to the integrity of the skin, open and the closed wound. Open wounds are the wounds that there is a loss of the skin. Closed wound, little blunt, that occurs with abdominal trauma. Closed wound, usually, example like contusion, mostly with bruises, usually due to like skin hematoma. Any development of skin hematoma under the skin would like contusion is considered a closed wound. According to the wound depth, as we said, partial or full thickness. Partial thickness, epidermis part, the epidermis and part of the dermis is being affected, but the full thickness, that's mean it will affecting, it's affecting the whole layers of the skin. Usually the missing tissue in the partial thickness will be replaced with the regeneration of the epidermis. It will need several days to several weeks to heal according to the patient condition. Full thickness involves the epidermis and the dermis and the underlying tissue, bone, muscle, and usually this type of the wound will take long time to heal, and sometimes it reaches to several months, and usually treatment will involve all the layers. Yani full thickness wound reaching the bone, you need to able to manage the bone. So the patient is having fracture, you need to fix the fracture. If you will need a graft, bone graft, you need to put bone graft. According to the morphological characteristics, bruise, contusion, we did a sore الحين كلنا هذه. Was by blunt trauma, damage to the tissue underlying the skin without breaking of the skin. It's due to scoliation into tissue. Blow to the chest, abdomen, and head. Hematoma, any collection of the blood below the skin or below the mucosa. Usually, it stays for several days, then it will liquefy. But if it is invaded by organisms, it will be an infected hematoma and will lead formation of pus. The crush wounds, it's a wound that will form after a crush injury. Usually this type of wound after falling of the heavy object, that will lead to splitting the skin and tearing of the underlying structure. Usually they are wounds that associate with deglobing and compartment syndrome. Abrasion, usually it's superficial and it will by infectization. Lacerated wound, كلها لها صور هذه. من اللي يخبرني what are the type of these wounds؟ يعني مثلا هذا الوند what is called
هذا البينس يا دكتور ولا لا؟
هذا بيرن يا دكتور.
ممتاز. هنا هذه الفكرة بالضبط. It could be a burn, it could be a chronic wound. صح ولا لا؟ لأنه it's a wound that is, يعني عشان كذا شباب احنا في الاكزامينيشن سوري في الاكزام there will be a scenario coming with it. A patient that had a burn injury, ويصير معها scenario that will guide you what is the intervention, what is the cause. مثل هذا it is a penetrating wound. usually this هذا usually a chronic wound due to bad chronic insufficiency. Even usually they're having peripheral vascular disease. Sometimes they can come with حاجة called filariasis, which is improper lymphatic supply or improper lymphatic drainage. That this usually, or could be a diabetic. This it's a laceration. This is a penetrating wound. This is could be a hematoma due to an injury. يعني الفكرة إنه السيناريو راح يجي بطريقة it will guide you what is the type of the wound and what is the cause and what's your next step. Patient with uncontrolled diabetes and this patient developed a lower limb ulcer which is not healing. Once it's not healing, what is your next step? These patients, my next step after doing the dressing, these patients should control their blood sugar to assess their vascular status and cover with the proper antibiotic. How to fix it, شباب? واضحة ولا لا؟ احتاج رد.
واضح يا دكتور واضح.
بس دكتور واضح.
طيب. Penetrated wound نفس اللي شفناها الصورة اللي قبل شوي. A foreign body with one opening. Perforation wound two openings. يعني an inlet و exit. مثل gunshot. طبعا according to the degree of the contamination ما بعيدة هذه. Clean, contaminated, dirty. هذه كل الأشياء هذه بس للتوضيح زيادة. طبعا ال wound healing. Definition of the wound healing. الفكرة إنه أنا عندي ال wound healing. طبعا المحاضرة هذه بعد ما خلصها في حاجة أبغى أضيفها عليها إنه once we know the pathology of the wound itself or what's the pathology of the wound healing, we will be able to define and to know what are the types of wound healing that will help us to make the wound to heal. يعني إيش معناه؟ It's the body natural response of restoring normal function and structure after injury. The entire wound healing is a complex series of events that begins at the moment of the injury and can continue for months to years. اللي تكلمنا عنها اللي هو inflammation, sorry, granulation, remodeling. هذه كلها it's a part of the wound healing. Type of the wound healing, there is primary and secondary and tertiary. Primary, بحط فيها صورة كل حاجة. The primary closure, إيش معنى primary closure؟ يعني you have a wound, you will close it primarily by approximation of the end. يعني عندك جرح خيطة, this is called primary wound healing. الجرح ما تخليه مفتوح. This is called the primary wound healing. Either you will use stitch, either you will use steri-stress, اللي وريتها لكم. This is called the primary wound healing. Usually these primary wound healings for clean wound. شفت كيف سويت انا يعني الحين انا نجمع الفكره مع بعض. يعني جاني مريض عملت له انا انجوانال هيرني اللي كانت الكلاسيفيكيشن حقها كلين سيرجري. How I will help in closing or healing of this wound, I will close it primarily by applying stitch. فأنا سويت mix يعني معناها إنه the wound because if it's clean, I will apply stitch لأنه primary صار هذا primary closure. لكنه لو كان dirty wound, I will not apply stitch لأنه once you apply stitch, there will be no primary closure. لأنه there is already an infection in the wound. معناه you will make it heal by a secondary closure. What is secondary healing intention? It is leaving the wound to be open and to heal by itself. This is called, this is used for contaminated and dirty wounds. Tertiary, which is called a delayed primary healing. What does tertiary? That you will leave it open, then after a while, then you will close it. طبعا, after a while, يعني, from 3 to 5 days, it can more. لكن أهم شيء حاجة أنه you will leave open in the beginning, then after some time, you will close it by stitch. طبعا نفس الفاكتورز local and systemic اللي حطيناها في المحاضرة الماضية. Complication of the wound. These are complications that happens usually after a wound, either dehiscence or evisceration, hemorrhage, adhesion, infection, herniation, fistula, sinus, suture complication, either scars, hypertrophy and keloid scar. طبعا management نفس ما قلنا of the wound, which are either primary or secondary closure, applying skin graft, flap. طبعا yes, so كلام حلو يا سيف. Does if you have a wound coming with a pus, leave the wound open, drain the pus and leave the wound open for some time till the pus stop. There will be no pus drainage. After that, you can close the wound, or you can leave the wound to heal by secondary intention, or you can do it by tertiary intention. تفضل يا سامي.
Do we take a biopsy from the pus or not?
Biopsy. What's my biopsy? اسمها swab. Biopsy is taken from the tissue. إذا كان chronic wound. لكن يجيك بس مريض عنده حصل له جرح في يده قبل امس وصار بده يجمع بس. انا less likely to be a chronic wound هذا اكيد لانه له يومين. I will open the wound, I will clean it, I will remove pus, I will remove all foreign body, I will remove the dead tissue, then I will clean it with vidine, with saline. Then after, if it's pus, I will leave it open for 3 or 5 days. I will take swab. I will take culture from the wound so to know what type of organism is causing. هذه الفكرة. ما فهمت يا سؤال السؤال كيف فهمت؟
قصدي دكتور الهيلينج يكون بالبرايمري ولا السكندري؟ هل يعتبر اوبن ولا يعتبر كلوست؟
اللي هي ايش؟ ما انتبهت للسؤال كمان اللي هي ايش؟
اللي هو السكن درافت اذا اخذت سكن من مكان معين وحطيت بمكان ثاني.
وش رايك السكن درافت عباره عن ايش؟ It is using it, you have a wound that did not close for a long time and you want to close it. Do you consider it as a second or third or sorry, a second primary ولا secondary ولا tertiary؟ وش رايك؟ انت عطني رايك بعد ما فهمنا الكونسبت احنا. طبعا هي فيها تفاصيل. هي الفكره كذا. شكرا لك. الفكره انك لازم تعرف في تفاصيل العمليه. يعني مثلا اذا كان انا اي بوت الجرافت والفلاب مباشره بعد العمليه, يعني مثل ما يسوون حالات الماستكتومي اللي هو بريست كانسر, ايش يسوون البلاستيك سيرجري؟ دي ريموف ذا بريست تيشو وبعدين يجيك البلاستيك سيرجري within the same operation. They will come, they will apply flap or graft. هذا وش صار, primary ولا secondary؟
Primary.
شفت؟ عشان كذا في concepts معينة انت اذا فهمت البرايمري I can apply it. ما هو معناه انه انا الفلاب ترى دائما يستخدم او دائما الجرافت يستخدم كبرايمري. انا ممكن بعدين البريست مثلا لنفرض نفس الحالة البريست سويت المريضة ماستكتومي ولا اني بس بعطيها راديشن بعد العملية ما سويت لها فلاب, سويت لها الفلاب بعد 6 شهور. Is it primary or secondary or tertiary؟
secondary.
لا ليش secondary؟ secondary بدأ أن يولد open and it will heal by itself. It's tertiary. صح.
نعم
فهمت يعني أنا الفكرة إنه ما أبغاك تربط الفلاب تراها دائما primary according to the scenario and according to the patient situation. لكن لو تقول لي يا دكتور patient with inguinal hernia وسوينا له inguinal hernia you will make it heal by secondary ولا tertiary ولا secondary ولا primary ولا secondary ولا tertiary. إذا قلت لي secondary أنا داري إنك معناه إنك ما أنت عارف لأنه the concept of the surgery yes. concept of the surgery هذه clean surgery عشان كذا شباب قلت لكم الوند هي ما هي مجرد محاضرة تفهمها بالنص this is عشان كذا تلاحظون هي mixed المحاضرة mixed في شيء من هنا وفي شيء من هنا عشان كذا ما حبيت أفصلها من بعض حبيت أن أربطهم مع بعض زي ما بنشرحها الحين مثلا الهيماتوما إذا كانت open هيماتوما جاني منده حصل له ضربة في يده كذا سيناريو كذا يصير حصل لي ضربة في يده وجمع هيماتوما الهيماتوما هذه طويل العمر فتحت بعد يومين وصارت تطلع بلد وتطلع بص الهيماتوما هذه راح أجيب ستيتش وأقفلها
لا تركها لأنه يطرح
you will leave it to heal by the secondary intention I will do dressing I will clean it I will make it heal by secondary intention يجيني واحد يقول يا دكتور I will close it by tertiary شو اسمه close I will do tertiary healing أقول لك هذا فيها كلام بس شي كذا أقول لك لا تفهمها ككون بس ككلمة مربوطة في شيء معين أنت الكونسبت وسيناريو إيش يصير مريض عنده حصل مثلا قاعد مثل بيجيني واحد طيب دكتور كيف التيرشري هيلينج يصير السيناريو حقه أنت سويت شوف في حالة واحدة بيصلح معها في ثلاث أنواع من التيرشري مثل مريض جاني العمل AR وجاني بساينز أوف أبندسايتس I took him for surgery the appendix was inflamed and I removed the appendix he went home الوند مكان الأبندix بعد جاني الملك بعد أسبوعين الوند نظيف الابندكس ما هي بكلين سيرجري الابندكس على حسب ما لقيت داخل العملية هذا السيناريو الأول إنه كانت انفليمد السيناريو الثاني نفس المريض جاني ابندكس دخلت العمليات لقيت الابندكس في بص صارت الحين contaminated I removed it جاني المريض بعد أسبوع الوند مليان بص I will open the wound, I will clean it, I will leave it to heal by itself, by secondary intention. نفس الفكرة, جاني مريض نفسه, inflamed appendix و gangrenous. جاني بعد أسبوع, الwound clean, dirty, وبس. I opened it. لكن قال يا دكتور, ترى أنا جاي من بعيد, أنا ما أقدر أخلي الwound مفتوح طول الوقت. أنا حاسس إني تشوف لي حل. After I أنا لو تلاحظون الأول ما فتحت للجرح قفلته لأن وما حصل فيه complication الثاني سيناريو الثاني المريض حصل له infection I opened it وقلت له مع الغيارات راح يقفل الجرح الثالث مريض دكتور أنا ما أبغى الجرح يكون مفتوح طول الوقت أنا عندي مشكلة ما أقدر أجي I will leave it open for 2 or 3 days then after that I will bring him again once I am sure that the wound is clean I will close it حط stitch فهمتوا كيف؟ يا شباب؟
على حسب
السيناريو لا تجيني تقول والله يا دكتور أنا حفظت فيك وتطبق خليك فليكس according to the patient condition according to the scenario that come يعني مثلا لو تشوفون هنا في treatment of bruise هنا usually bruise it is there is no management usually will heal by itself لكن لو جاني البروز معه infection بقول له والله معليش هذا بروز أنا الدكتور فهمنا إنه بروز ما في له treatment لا treat the infection أنا أعطيك concepts contusion مثلاً اللي بعده. محمد
دكتور، بس انا في عندي نقطة ابيها، هل هي صحيح عندي ولا لا؟ اذا كان مثلا في السكندري والتيرشري انت تقول خلي الجرح مفتوح، يعني قصدك انت ما اخذ اول شيء، حط مثلا جاوز ومثلا معاقم الجرح يومين ثلاثه بعدين اسوي له سوترنج.
ممتاز. بعدين هذا في التيرشري، لكن في السكندري ويل نوت ابلاي تو ستيتش. في السكندري راح تخليه راح يتابع معك يغير في الجرح لين يقعد شهر.
تمام يعطيك العافيه.
التيرشري يقول لك والله دكتور يقفل، انا مثلا خلاص ما عاد اقدر اكمل، او انت شفت الجرح تبغى يقفل بسرعه الجرح، مثلا المريض يقول لك والله يا دكتور انا مثلا جاي من بعيد، انا بالله ساعدني يعني بعد 3 ايام 4 ايام انا خلاص بسافر مثلا اقفل لبزتش. هذا صار تيرشري، اني تركته في البدايه مفتوح فتره معينه الين صار الجرح نظيف بعدين قفلته. اوكي
تمام.
عشان شباب محاضرة الوند، وند هو عبارة عن ترم كذا، ترم عبارة عن مصطلح فيه تفاصيل. انت اذا عرفت الكونسبتس، زي مثلا الساينس، جاني مريض جاني بساينس مثلا زي البايلونودال ساينس، الناسور العصعصي، بعد ما سويت العملية وشلت له الناسور صار مكان الناسور وند، صار جرح. طيب يا دكتور هذا بينس، هذا ساينس، وش يسوي له هذا يا دكتور؟ هذا طبق عليه اي مبدأ؟ تطبيق المبدأ العادي اللي هو وند على حسب انت تركته مفتوح ولا يو كلوزد ات باي برايمري، حطيت له ستيتش هذا صار اسم برايمري وند هيلينج، والله تركته مفتوح صار سكندري وند هيلينج. الدايجنوسيس حقي كان ساينس فقط، لكني في النهايه انا قاعد احوم حول مبدا او تيرم اسمه الوند. واضح يا شباب ولا لا؟ هيماتوما، الهيماتوما نفس الكرة، it should be evacuated if it's a brain or if it's an area. Once it's small, leave it by itself, it will heal. The most important thing to avoid infection. The puncture wound, it is usually there will be breakage of the skin. معناها there will be affection of the subcutaneous tissue, there will be foreign body. The most important thing, as we said, إنه clean it, irrigate, give tetanus, remove the foreign body, and according to the condition itself, either you will clean, you will close it, or you will make it open. The most important thing also, don't forget to do radiological investigation like X-ray to check if there is no other foreign body that you will not be able to see it. يعني مريض يكون عنده مثلا يا شباب حصل له RTA والقزاز تكسر عليه وجايك wound عند arm، انت did all the cleaning of the wound لكن you are not sure there is any wound or there is any glass or not, there is any في قطع مثلا حديد او قطع اي حاجه باقيه في الوند انت ما تقدر تشوفها. You will do X-ray, it will guide you. طبعا الفكرة انه all these things are done to avoid infection. The most important thing to clean the wound and explore the wound. If there is any dead tissue, remove it. If there is any irrigation, do it. If there is any need for antibiotic, give. Abrasion, usually abrasion, it's like or friction burn. Usually a coat, is it involving superficial or deep or full thickness? نفس الكونسبت حقتها. If there is any infection, avoid it, clean it, remove the foreign body. If there is any dead tissue, remove the tissue, cover the wound, leave it healed by secondary intention. You can apply any medication that will assist to help to assist the heal, to assist in the healing. Laceration, it is an injury that involves opening of the sharp opening of the skin. Usually, once there is involving the superficial or deep, نفس الفكره شباب، بس انا الفكره انه انا ابغى لما تسمع accept laceration تحط في بالك it is something that affected the skin integrity، ممكن due to surgery، ممكن due to wound. The very important thing انك تشوف is it deep, is it superficial, is there is any dead tissue, is there is any foreign body, is there is any type of infection, there is any need of primary repair or you will leave it as a secondary. طبعا traction or avulsion زي كذا. avulsion وش معنى avulsion؟ نفس degloving injury. It's a type of زي مثلا يجيك احيانا عامل دخلت يده في ماكينه تقطيع او زي كذا، فيجيك زي كذا injury that will involve degloving or loss of the skin. اي نفس الكونسبت يا فيصل. open injuries where has been severe degree of tissue damage such injury to the hand of the limb and trapping in a movement machinery such as rollers producing degloving injury. يعني زي هذا يا شباب، زي هذا. يعني انا ودي يعني مثلا what do you think is what is the treatment that should be done for this. يلا ابغى واحد جاوب.
اعتقد الدكتور ممكن تيرشري، ممكن يصير فيه بص ويصير فيه.
لا انا الحين انا بقول what is the treatment، انا ما قلت what is the healing treatment. شباب المهم انك تفهم السؤال. انا ما قلت healing treatment like this patient. انا الحين جاني هذا
الدكتور heal the wound immediate close up لانه ممكن سكيب موت اذا ضل يعني
مكان. لا 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 سوري ما لا هذه ما يجي. لا كلين ذا وند اوكي بديت صح بتخربتها.
فيرست بعد ما اسوي كلين دكتور.
جايز انجلش جايز ها سو ذات وي كان انسر فيري ويل. تفضل يا معاذ ستارت.
افتر وي كلين ذا وونز وي ستوب ذا بليدنج اني بليدنج وي لوكينج فور اني بليدنج.
انت develop a system for yourself so that you will be able to have cover everything. First, when the patient comes to me in the AR, I will first the general condition of the patient. صح. The patient was involved in this type of a trauma. That's mean I should know is this patient, how is his general condition? Maybe he will reach the AR or to the hospital and he bled a large amount of blood. So I will assess him in the beginning. I will ask what is the history exactly, what happened, is he, when he developed this thing, maybe he had it before 2 days. فهمت الفكرة؟ لأنه according to it you will plan. Then you will ask about any loss of the motor function, can he move his hand or not. الفكره انت الحين عند هذا المريض يقول لك والله انا قبل لا تصير لي المشكله كنت احرك يدي، لكن الحين صرت ما اقدر احرك يدي، معناها انك يا دكتور انت عالجتني غلط. بينما if you assist him very well before starting the treatment you will document and you will know that he developed deficiency in the limb function. يعني صار مثلا he cannot move his first and second finger. فهمت الفكرة يا شباب؟ يعني صح. مهم جدا يكون عندك baseline to know what is his condition before starting the treatment. His neurological status, his neurological examination, musculoskeletal examination, assess of the vascular supply. Then after that I will start my examination. I will clean the wound, I will remove foreign body, I will cover the wound, I will use this skin to cover the wound. If there is any dead tissue, I will remove it. I will cover with antibiotic. I will expect to assess the bone. I will remove any dead tissue. هذه الفكرة شباب إنه this type of injury. هذا wound. شوفوا شباب هذا wound. هذا المحاضرة كلها الكاملة نتكلم. راح أشرح له إنه ترى your wound will not be closed primarily. We will use a secondary or tertiary. Secondary, that means I will leave the wound for some time. Then after that, with the dressing, I will see if there is good healing. I will apply stitch. فهمت الكونسيبت يا شباب؟ هذه كذا هذه الصورة هي ملخص المحاضرة كاملة. هذا البيشنت if he is diabetic, I will inform him that if he did not control his diabetes, the wound will not heal. If the patient is using any medication, I will ask him to stop the medication that will affect the healing. فهمتوا يعني هذه الصورة ملخص الكلام اللي what do we mean by saying wound. Crush injuries, نفس الفكرة. Most important, get crush injuries. Check these patients have a good, proper blood supply. طبعاً الصورة اللي قبله حاجة قبل شوي. تذكرون في المحاضرة حقت الأبدومنال اللي يوم تكلمنا عن الكومبارتمنت ما كومبارتمنت. هنا نيجي نتكلم عن الكومبارتمنت سيندروم في اللبس. Usually when you close the wound and because of the primary closure and because the edema of the wound, there is a risk that the pressure inside the limb will increase and the lower limb will be under pressure. That will increase the risk of developing parts in. عشان كذا حط في بالك انه if you close to primarily, there is a risk of compartment. Once he will come with symptoms of compartment, I will open. Fasciotomy is part one of the way of opening a wound. طبعا الفكرة نفس الفكرة. Injury to the arteries of the vein, control the bleeding, assess the limb, assess the perfusion, don't apply tourniquet. طبعا اللي بيقرا بعدين في الفسيولوجي او الباثوفسيولوجي اوف ذا وند هيلينج بروسيس او ممكن الريموديلينج والتيشو سكارينج. There are types of tissue scar, hypertrophic and keloid scar. Hypertrophic remained convent to the original site, extend beyond the original site. It occur on the shoulders, knees. This is at the sternum air loops. Develop after injury rapidly, develop within month, rapid growth, persistent for years, no association with pigmentation, higher association with pigmentation, high density of collagen and fibrosis, thick with mucin. In our differences between hypertrophic and keloid scar. طبعا أنا المحاضرة معدل فيها خصوصا المحاضرة الأولى شايل منها أشياء كثير. لكن يحتاج اني ارجعها مره ثانيه علشان نفهم بالضبط الكونسبت حق الهيلينج بروسيس. How is healing او الوند يعني what is the first cells that come in the beginning, when the microphages will come. بعدلها وبضيف عليها الكلام اللي يحتاج عشان لما تقرونه يكون سهل بالنسبه لكم. وفي some pictures will be added for more clearance. Okay. Any questions, شباب؟ في شيء مو واضح حق نضيفه؟
دكتور في الهيستوري مثلا الهيستوري اسال البيشن يعني وش اللي مثلا سويته في الهيلينج يعني مثلا حطيت مثلا الكحول السواب يعني هذا ممكن
you will ask the patient في شيء اوسع. You will ask the patient what you did for the wound. Some people will tell I applied honey. يجيك واحد يقول لك والله انا حط عسل الوند. Some people will tell you والله I will apply it مثلا في ثقافه في المجتمع يقول لك والله انا حطيت مثلا قرفه حطيت يعني يعطيك you should know what was done for the wound. So it will guide you. يعني once these things applied you need to clean it and remove it. Because these things are considered foreign bodies. بغض النظر عن يعني الانطباع اللي عند الناس انه it will enhance healing. This is are considered foreign body. ف
دكتور الخوى جوا يعني ينفع ولا الوند الخوى جوا يعني في رايك الشخصي يعني يسوي contaminated ولا كويس الجرح يعني
لا تسألني عن الأشياء هذه. This is not my specialty. ما في حاجة اسمه using إحنا herbal medication to treat. إحنا أطباء. herbal ما درسنا شيء اسمه herbal. herbal تبع الناس الherbal. فقول لي والله يا دكتور كلورهكسيدين موفيداين this is enhance healing. أقول لك it will enhance healing in this way. لكن خوة جوا قرف أشياء هذه this is not my specialty. This is not my specialty. I will not answer something which is not in my field. أنا مين من اللي بيتفلسف حاجة ما تخص.
دكتور تسمح لي.
تفضل.
Regarding next week, next Sunday we have a quiz. I think this lecture we have 5 lectures with you. That will be in the quiz one. So, doctor, all the 5 lectures is included, or in today lecture it will not be included.
هذا الشيء مع الدكتور أحمد والمحاضرات involved إلين الأسبوع اللي قبل الاختبار. يعني عبد الرحمن يعني محاضرة شرحناها الأحد والاختبار راح يكون الأحد الجاي. تتوقع إني بقول لك يا عبد الرحمن لا والله not involved؟ معروف إحنا محاضرة لها أسبوع مشروحة. وفيها زيادات أنا برسلها لكم زيادة. This is a big concept. وانت أنا قاعد أدرس basics. لو يجيني أحد في سنة سادس راح يكون الطريق التدريس غير. لكن this is basic. وانت يجيني سنة سادس ما تعرف إيش هو الوانت راح كأننا رجعنا سنتين قدام وسنتين وراء. ف this is something clear واضح. تكلمت أنا بوضوح تام وهذا أنا قاعد أسأل في شيء. I can clarify it more I'm ready. The cases will become either as direct or a case scenario. It will be clear. Fixtures, I will add it more عشان توضح. زي الهايبرتروفي سكار كيلويد سكار يحتاج ان نشوف لها صور اكثر. الوند هيلينج باي اتسلف الفسيولوجي اوف ذا وند يعني لانه لو تكلمنا فيها يعني هتاخذ منا وقت لكن خليني بس اضبطها واعدلها واحط الاضافات اللي تكون واضحه للجميع اللي يقعد يقراها يفهمها. وات ار انا وش في اكثر من اني علشان اشرح البرايمري والسكندري هيلينج شرحت كيس 3 كيس سيناريو. البوند ويل بي كلين اتس كلين. There will be infection and there will be gangrene. يعني هذه واضحة. يعني أنا شباب ما راح أنا شرحت الكونسبت. لما أشرح الكونسبت خلاص معناه إنه السيناريو should be within applying within the concept. Patient coming with post perforated appendix and upon within inside the surgery, the appendix was gangrenous with stool contamination and pus. What type of wound this wound? It's clean, contaminated ولا dirty? واحد يجاوبني.
Dirty.
يعني بالله يعني يجيني واحد يقول لي والله يا دكتور contaminated ولا clean contaminated. معناه انك الكونسبت ما فهمته. اذا ما فهمت الكونسبت هذه مشكله. معناه انك مسكت سلايد حفظت الكلمه شفت الابندكس محطوطه في الكلين كونتامينيتد او كونتامينيتد ودخلت المحاضره وانت حافظها. معناه انك ما فهمت المحاضره. شوف المحاضره از جايد از جايدنس ما هو نفس اللي موجود لازم نفس اللي مكتوب فيها. انا اشرح اوكي. سؤال ثاني يا شباب. سؤال ثاني يا شباب. طيب عبد الرحمن مكلمني قايل لي علشان المحاضرة حقت التروما انه في اشياء مش فاهمينها.
البارت الأخيرة دكتور فقط اللي هي الـ grades حتى
الجريدز. ايش اللي انتم فاهمين فيها الجريدز؟
يعني ما انشرحت يا دكتور.
لا انشرحت يا بتكلم عن لسريش. ما عبد الرحمن لا تقول لي ما انشحت. تكلمنا عن اللسريشن، تكلمنا في الثيرد ديجري الليبر، either I will do conservative, I will observe the patient vitals. شباب ابغى اجابه من الجميع. المحاضره حقت الابدومن التروما، الجريدز اوف ذا تروما، شو رايك ولا
ما شرحت؟ ما شرحت يا دكتور.
شرحت
ما شرحت
غير قول ما شرحت.
شرحت يا دكتور شرحت، بس ان جنرال يعني شرحت انها على السريع اللي هو الجريد 1 الى جريد 3 كانت نسوي لها كونزيرفل، بس من جريد 4 جريد 5 على طول غالبا يكون.
ايش سؤال ايش الشيء اللي ما واضح فيها؟ ابغى احد يقول لي يا دكتور مثلا احنا ما فهمنا وش معنى كلمه لاسريشن. ابغى كذا انا هذا. طيب اوكي مدام في اجماع من الجميع. عبد الرحمن لازم يبغى لها وقت زياده، وانتم عندكم محاضره بتبدا الساعه 10.
طيب تبغى بالليل دكتور ولا بكره؟
اي بالليل احسن. نقعد على ناخذ نص ساعه يعني من 9 وكذا 9 عليها ناخذ نص ساعه وجايز بليز انا اي وونت كويستشنز. يعني لما يجي واحد يقول لي دكتور وات دو يو مين باي ذس سلايد،
طيب
راح يكون نقاشنا كذا. انا ما راح افتح المحاضره واتكلم. ابغى دكتور
الابدومينال تروما، صح دكتور؟
ريجاردنج الابدومينال تروما عشان للشخص اللي ما هو فاهم حاجه انا اكسبلين ات. انا ما راح المحاضره ما راح اعيدها لسبب واحد، انه ما ابغى اعيد نفس النظري. Now it will be as a discussion. يجي واحد يقول لي دكتور what do you mean by type 1 grade؟ اقول لك this is a grade that has been done by CT. تاخذ المريض تسوي له CT. Once the radiology see that there is a laceration less than 1 centimeter, he will give you a report that it's a grade 1 liver injury due to there is one laceration or 1 centimeter laceration. Lacerations mean there is a small opening or an opening less than 1 centimeter. مثل يتكلم it's a wound, it is a wound in the liver. لكن مشكلته انه wound inside the liver. So the treatment will be conservative. لانه it's a laceration that you cannot go inside and you cannot do primary repair. The liver is a regeneration tissue. It will close by itself. فهمت الكلام كده؟ واضح كده كشرح كده أتوقع أنه أوضح، صح؟ أحتاج أحد يرد علي ولا لا؟
واضح يا دكتور واضح إن شاء الله.
طيب نبغى عبد الرحمن بيني وبينك تواصلنا على الواتساب بالضبط متى عشان نرتب مع الشباب.
الله يعطيك العافية.
الله يستر عليك. الله يستر عليك. الله يستر عليك. الله يستر عليك.